The double degree programs are either 4 or 5 years. The ones with international relations and writing and creative communication are 4-year double degree programs. The one with law is a 5-year program. And what it means to do a double degree is that you end up with 2 degrees at the end. So you get one nice piece of paper that says Bachelor of Journalism and another one that says Bachelor of Arts, Writing and Creative Communication. And the way it's set up is to allow you to study both of those areas within a relatively short time. So rather than having to spend 3 years studying journalism and then maybe another bit of time studying international relations, it's combined into one. So it's a great way for people who have got quite a wide range of interests to really be able to explore those. For example, for people who love writing but are not really entirely sure what they want to do with their writing career, something like the double degree between journalism and writing and creative communication is great because it allows you to explore a whole lot of different types of writing, from creative writing to journalistic writing to technical and professional writing. You can cover the lot. So just some thoughts about where students end up or where graduates of journalism end up. Not surprisingly, of course, a lot end up working in mainstream media. So things like newspapers, radio, television, and so on. A lot also end up working for magazines or for in-house publications. A lot of large companies or large organizations produce regular newsletters which they circulate to their staff or to their clients or to whoever it might be. For example, ratepayers in the case of councils. And so journalists are often employed to work on those because it's the same kinds of skills that go with working for mainstream television or mainstream newspapers, but it's used in a slightly different way. Journalists also move into areas like public relations and communications. One of the great things about a journalism degree is that it doesn't just equip you to work as a journalist. It equips you with a range of skills that are extremely useful in journalism, but also apply very well in other communications kinds of areas. So, for example, the ability to write well, to communicate well, to research well, and so on. Those are the kinds of skills that a journalism degree equips you with, but it also means you can use those in a vast range of other areas as well. So journalists often work also for government departments in a range of capacities, and some work for themselves as freelance journalists. So the kinds of places that you can see recent graduates working around Adelaide, around the state, and even internationally, things like Channel 7, Channel 9, Channel 10, the ABC, radio, whether it's for the ABC or commercial radio, newspapers in Adelaide, newspapers around the state, and in fact, internationally as well. There are a number of graduates of the program who are working in places like Los Angeles. And as I said before, local, state, and federal government. So lots of opportunities for journalists to work in a range of areas. And certainly, if I switch on the TV at any point or pick up a newspaper, I can be pretty sure that if I'm certainly in South Australia and often within Australia, that I'll recognise a name or a few names of people who have been through the UniSA journalism degrees. So a few things about journalism, excuse me, as a career. It's often seen as a very glamorous kind of career, and certainly it has elements that are, I guess, glamorous. You get to do things that most people don't get to do. You get to meet people that most people don't get to meet. Politicians, celebrities, the Dalai Lama, all sorts of people that you wouldn't otherwise have an opportunity to encounter. And you get to go to, you know, terrific events like the Olympics and so on if you're very lucky. So that's one of the tremendous things about working as a journalist. Unfortunately, most people who are journalists don't get to do those things every day, but nonetheless, they tend to be the highlights of people's careers. However, for most people, starting work as a journalist, coming straight out of uni, most of the jobs that are there are to be found in newspapers. And in fact, most of those jobs are found in regional newspapers. And for those of you who are not from a regional area, that might not sound like exactly where you might want to go initially, but I can tell you that it's a great experience. Journalists working for small regional newspapers get to do everything. They get to cover the kind of stories they would never be able to cover as a junior journalist working for major metropolitan media. So it is actually a terrific starting point for a career in journalism. And you know, realistically, that's where the majority of the jobs tend to be in the shorter term as well. A lot of journalists spend a lot of time interviewing on the phone rather than out face-to-face. TV journalism is, of course, a little bit different because it has to be. You need people in front of a camera to be able to make TV journalism stories work. but for particularly newspaper journalists, often a lot of time is spent on the phone. Another thing which is very central to journalism is deadlines. Everything about journalism is based on meeting a deadline, whether it's the next edition of a print newspaper or the next deadline for a TV bulletin, or even the fact that when your stories are going up on your news outlet's website, that you have to get them there as soon as you possibly can. So journalism is a career that works particularly well for people who like working under a bit of pressure and like working to a tight deadline. It's not, as people often think, usually tremendously creative writing, particularly initially. If you are a great creative writer, journalism may not be, well, certainly daily news journalism may not be something that is your first choice. But what it can lead into is a career in feature writing, which is much more creative. But the good bits about all of it, as I said before, essentially you get to do all sorts of different things in all sorts of different environments. You get paid to do things which I think are pretty good fun, talking to people and writing. You get to travel, either within an individual job or journalism is, the skills of journalism are very portable, so it's quite easy to go and work in another part of the world, for example, and a lot of journalists do that. It is the kind of job where you come into work in the morning and you don't really know necessarily what you're going to be doing that day. You might spend a day in the office on the phone, you might get told to get on a plane because you're going to Alice Springs. Anything's possible, and that's one of the things that most journalists love about the job, is that you really don't know from any one day to the next exactly what you're going to be doing. And of course there are all sorts of different opportunities that are coming along with new media as well. As more and more news outlets are establishing substantial presences online, and there is more of a shift towards online news as an alternative to traditional formats of news, more opportunities are opening up there as well. So it's a great kind of career to be at the centre of things, to be involved in what's going on, to be interacting with people, to be writing about it. So just, excuse me, a couple of points about studying journalism at UniSA. First of all, it is the only university journalism program in South Australia. Another institution who shall remain nameless has a media degree, but it's not journalism. A media degree is a more broad-based, more theoretical program that focuses on a range of different areas of media. The UniSA program is the only one that focuses specifically on journalism and particularly on the skills that are needed to be a journalist. The people teaching in the program have a mix of academic and practical backgrounds. Everyone, I think, who is teaching full-time in the journalism degree has worked as a journalist, and in most cases for quite some years as a journalist. I spent 17 years as a print journalist, for example, before moving into teaching. So we have people who've got a background in radio journalism, in TV journalism, in print journalism, and so on. So people who understand how journalism works, but also people who have an academic background which enables them to teach it and to pass those skills and that knowledge on. And generally speaking, the UniSA program has a pretty good reputation nationally. A few years ago, I think it was The Australian did a survey of the journalism programs around Australia. I think there are about 30 of them all up, and we came out in the top five, so that was pretty good. We have some good close links with industry. We have our own news website, which the students produce and put together. They do all the writing for, they do all the editing. It's called On the Record. We've got very close links with industry in South Australia, Victoria, and New South Wales. We use a lot of people from industry to come and act as guest speakers. And we've got some terrific new facilities, which I'll flick to a couple of shots of in a moment. Journalism students are also involved in producing a publication called The Globalist, which if I can get to it very quickly, I'll click on the link. Essentially, the South Australian version of The Globalist is one of a group of international publications which actually started out of Yale University in the US. And so it's a very small and elite, I guess, group of universities around the world that produce this publication called The Globalist, which focuses on international relations and other kinds of internationally focused issues. It's the second Australian one. There's one in Sydney and there's this one. And that's another outlet for students to become involved in. And you can see here the TV and the radio studios. And if you go to the Ghana building after this and go into the comm zone, you'll see some of this equipment set up, and also we've got some lovely panoramic shots of the TV studios and the other studios as well. So this is a terrific state-of-the-art facilities which we opened at the start of this year. It's got what are known as virtual sets, which essentially are computer-generated sets. So if we put a student behind a desk to read the news, for example, what you actually see on the screen is this whole big set behind them. It looks terrific. And this is a student working in front of the green screen, which is where that allows the virtual sets to be generated. We've also got a radio studio, which again is state-of-the-art, tremendous facilities for students to use, and we make a lot of use of those. Some of the opportunities that students have within the program are to go on international exchanges or be part of what's known as the Hawk Ambassador Program, where students can undertake often journalism-focused work in another part of the world. All students in their final year undertake a journalism placement, and we also do quite a bit of collaborative work with what used to be known as Channel 31, but is now called Channel 44, the community TV station in Adelaide. So the kinds of things that students have been involved in, particularly with Channel 44, coverage of the World Police and Fire Games. They were here in Adelaide about 3 years ago. And then a group of students also went over to Liverpool in the UK where they had the World Firefighter Games. A couple of years ago, we had students involved in shooting news stories and current affairs type stories at the World Beach Volleyball titles. And then last year, there were a group of students involved in doing coverage of the Special Olympics. So if you want more information, that's the contact details there. I'd also strongly recommend you go along, if you've got any questions, to the comm zone in the Garner building after this, where I'll be available, other staff will be available, and also some current students will be available to talk to you a little more and to answer any questions that you might have. Now I'm going to hand over to one of our lovely current students, Jordan, who is going to he's just going to give you a little brief rundown on what it's like to be a journalism student. I'll give you this.
Is that on? That's
on.
Okay, fantastic. So my name is Jordan Archer. I'm in my final semester of a double degree in journalism and international studies. So approximately 8 years ago, I was sitting in the same spot as all of you in year nine thinking, oh, is this what I want to do? And turns out it was. And as the moment I started my course, I realized, yep, this is definitely what I want to do. So hopefully you'll get it and feel the same way. I've really enjoyed my 4 years here at uni. I went into the degree and sort of had my mind blown at how varied the field of journalism can be. I went in thinking, oh yeah, I'd like to work for a newspaper. And then, you know, I'm at the point now where I think radio production is where I want to go into, because throughout the course, you get a feel for all the different areas, print, online, radio, broadcast. And I think it's great because, you know, you get all these tasters and you sort of think everything, oh yeah, I want to do that. And then it's like next week, oh no, I want to do that. But, you know, by the end of the degree, you sort of have an area you're really interested in. While I want to do radio production, that might not be where I get a job straight away, but eventually I hope that's where I end up. You also get to do some other things like basic layout. You can do sports journalism if that's what you're really keen on. You get to do shorthand, which is a really nifty way of writing. It's fun to show your friends and be like, can you read this? No, no one else can read it. It's amazing. Now, it's really interesting to write for each medium. It's really interesting how it sort of becomes second nature. Like, it's strange to be in my fourth year and realize that, yeah, picking out what is newsworthy, knowing what information to include, knowing how to write it, it's, yeah, no, like the back of my hand, which is kind of weird because you start to forget that everyone else doesn't feel the same way. Your friends write something, it's like, why did you write that like that? Like, and you realize it's something that I have picked up, so the course has done something right. I feel like I think and write like a journalist now. If you're considering applying for a double degree, it's definitely something I would recommend. Personally, I got the travel bug a long time ago, and I would love to work overseas one day. So I think international studies has definitely helped me with that. It's really given me a better understanding of how the world works because it's a real sort of politics degree teaching you about world politics. And you also get to do a language. I did a couple of years of French, and I'd love to work in France and get a job there one day, hopefully. Some of the most rewarding parts of the course are the opportunities for practical experience. It's a very competitive field, journalism, when it comes to getting jobs. Saying that, it's definitely on my mind at the moment, since I'm finishing in a few months. So it's really important to get some experience during your degree to make yourself more marketable. For me, that's included doing volunteer producing at Radio Adelaide, a community radio station, and editing the Uni Life magazine, which is sort of a magazine about the student experience. It's a lot of fun. So I've got those on my resume to sort of say, I've got some experience, I don't just have a degree. You also, as Catherine said, do placements in your final year. I did 2 weeks at the ABC, and they were the most rewarding weeks of my entire degree, just seeing the way a newsroom operates and the way, you know, and being like, oh, this will be me one day. Like, that was really exciting, and the contacts I made, I also hope to use to hopefully get a job. I mean, that's sometimes it does come down to who you know, and I'm hoping to use the people I now know. While it sounds somewhat daunting to say, you know, you have to do all this other experience, you're only going to be at uni for about 12 to 15 hours a week. It's not that much, so you do have the time to work part-time and get that experience. If I were to pick a highlight of my university career, it would have to be the semester I studied overseas on exchange. I went to a university called Ryerson, which is in Toronto, Canada. I studied there for one semester, 4 months, and they have a brilliant journalism program. I got to do some subjects that, you know, aren't offered at most universities, really. I got to do a photojournalism course, and now I like to think of myself as a bit of an amateur photographer, but, you know, that's probably boasting myself a bit too much. But it's really added something else to my education, and it's the sort of experience that really made me feel like I had the world at my feet. I could do anything and go anywhere. And I made friendships that are going to really last me a lifetime as well. And I have free accommodation halfway around the world. You know, I can go to Canada and have a free bed. So that'll save me some money, hopefully, one day. And finally, just studying here at UniSA, I've made a number of really close friends. It's not the sort of course where you have 500 people in a lecture theatre. It's not going to be as jam-packed as this room right here. You'll get to have the same classes with the same people, and you'll make really close bonds with them. And you also get to know your tutors and lecturers very well. Catherine will probably know your name by the end of it, which, you know, is good, because there's people in science degrees, 500 people, cheer will have no idea who you are, so it's good to actually make those contacts with your tutors and lecturers, because they can help you out as well. And yeah, great friends, and it's a really funny thing in that in 3 months' time, we're all going to be competing to get jobs when we've been all buddy-buddy for the last 3 years, but it doesn't matter when you're in... It doesn't really matter when you're in the course. Everyone's not super competitive already, okay? So you'll have a lot of fun while doing it, both in the course and just with friends. So really worthwhile course. I've really enjoyed it. And I'm kind of sad that in 3 months I have to, you know, get a full-time job and enter the real world. Yeah. Yes.
Pick up on one of the points that Jordan made, and thank you very much for that, Jordan. That was great. And we didn't even have to pay you to say all those nice things. just picking up on, Jordan was talking about studying shorthand and studying sports journalism and so on. One of the things with the journalism degree, and as I said, about half of it is focusing specifically on journalism. Students do most of that as what are called compulsory or core courses, which cover a range of journalism skills. Because what we're very careful of, and we've actually restructured the degree a little bit for this 2011 and going forward into 2012, we restructured the degree a bit because we're aware of the fact that more and more journalism graduates are being asked to go into the industry with a wide range of skills. So it's important that every journalist or every journalism graduate can not only write for, you know, newspapers, but also now knows how to use a video camera, for example, to produce work for TV, because increasingly... journalists are working in single-person, what are known as video journalism newsrooms, where essentially the journalist is the person who not only goes out there and covers the story and writes the story, but also shoots it with their video camera. So we've actually rearranged the degree, I guess, a bit to encompass the fact that people graduating from journalism need to cover a whole range of skills. But within that, we do also have some opportunities for elective choices for things like sports journalism or shorthand or advanced television or advanced radio or advanced print, for people who've got a particular area of interest that they really want to focus on and they really want to develop their skills in. And the other point that Jordan made about going out there and getting some experience, that's not only probably one of the most fun parts of studying journalism, but it's also very important in terms of developing a portfolio and developing the kind of skills and background and understanding that help you to stand out at the end when, yeah, as you discover in your final year, you're suddenly competing against all those people that you've had a wonderful time with for the past 3 or 4 years, because it is a competitive area to get into. So the more that people can develop their skills along the way and get opportunities for experience, whether it's in a newsroom or whether it's with something like On the Record, which is the student publication that I talked about, or The Globalist, or UniLife, which is the student association magazine, or volunteering with through one of our projects with Channel 44, the better that graduates are going to be equipped to find work. So I'm going to turn over to questions now, and you're welcome to ask Jordan or me or both in the last few minutes that we've got available. So any questions? Yeah. The actual intake, it varies from year to year, but a typical intake, and this is across the four journalism degrees, so not just any one of them, is about 160 students, most of whom will go on and graduate in 3 or 4 years. Okay, we do get some students who perhaps decide a year down the track that, you know, journalism isn't quite what they thought it might be and might transfer into something like creative writing, but the majority of those students do go right through the program. So it's usually about 160 students as an intake. Any more questions? Oh, yep. Yep. It is possible. Generally, it comes down to individuals to organise that because we don't have enormous contacts overseas, but there's no reason that it can't be done. Yeah. And it's usually a fairly short-term internship, which actually helps to make it easier. It's not like, I don't know what other area, that some of them have, you know, quite, you know, 3 or 4 month internships. Ours generally tend to be a few weeks. You know, a week or two or three or four. So that makes it easier to organise something, but it is possible to do it overseas, yes. Any other questions? We've clearly told people everything they need to know. Well done. Okay, well, if there are no other questions, thank you very much for coming along. If you're interested in finding out more about journalism or any of the other School of Comm and International Studies and Languages programs, please come along to McGill Night on the Wednesday, the 7th of September, out at the McGill campus, which is where we're based. And there's plenty of opportunities, if you have any questions that you want to ask today, to come along to the Garner building. Will be there, Jordan will be there, I'll be there. And you can ask any questions that you have then. Thanks very much.